up our guest connects with executives and entrepreneurs across the country, sharing secrets on how to grow a business. And now he's opening up the pages of his book to share them with you.
Joining us now, best-selling author and podcast host, Paul Edwards. Great to have you in studio.
Welcome in.
Thanks for having me. Great to be here.
It's been a real pleasure talking to you over the past hour, getting to know all about what you're doing in the space, working with business owners and entrepreneurs. You had a book that came out, this spring?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Yeah. Tell us all about the book.
Well, it's basically came from about 6 years in the insurance business. And the one thing I learned about insurance is nobody wants to talk about insurance.
Nope.
Right? So I figured out, well, I've got to have something else to offer when I meet people and when I form relationships with them. So what I started studying was marketing and relational capital and how to build connection with people. Mm. And I became so invested in it and so, I don't want to say good at it, but better than I used to be at it.
Yeah.
Right.
That I decided I'm going to write a book about this and teach others how to do it.
See, it's not just about, they're not buying just the name of your company. They're buying you, your smile, how you communicate. What role does effective communication play when growing a business?
Effective communication, I always like to go back to journalism since we're in the context here.
Excellent.
If you are continually asking people who, what, where, when, why, and how, right? If you use those rules as conversation pieces, as you get to know people, remain continually focused on what they tell you, especially if they begin to tell you pain points.
Yeah.
It becomes it opens up a world of useful information that you can then use to leverage and add value to people.
Don't just hear them, listen to them.
Correct.
And respond to it. Don't get ready for your next question.
Yeah. There's such a big difference, isn't there? Mm-hmm. Do you hear me listen to you when you,
Not you trying to show off, it's all right.
No, real-time
example. Yeah.
You've distilled it down to 5 networking tips, and you're going to take us through them right now.
Okay, so the first one is be an angler, and what I mean by this is don't go to a networking function or a luncheon or anything like that to transact business. Go there for business reasons.
Gotcha.
And there's a subtle distinction there, but the main thing is you're not going there to sell. You're going there to meet people and create opportunities and learn about opportunities you otherwise wouldn't.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the first one. The second one is what I call keep your ear to the ground. And so this is being a scout, right? This is basically looking for, knowing about, having in the back of your head opportunities for the people you meet. Right, based on what they tell you, all of a sudden you have a giant Rolodex of people and opportunities you know that you can connect them with.
Mm-hmm.
The third is done-for-you publicity. So I use this with my podcast. There's any number of ways you can do it, but you basically create a platform to promote other people that you meet in business rather than get on social media or wherever and talk about yourself.
Yeah, absolutely.
Right? Mm-hmm. There's 3 big questions. This is number 4. 3 big questions I always keep in mind. If none of those other things work, you can always ask people these 3 questions. What's going well for you? What's not going so well for you? And what are you looking forward to?
Yep.
These are different than saying, hey, what's new?
Or
what do you do? Right? Mm-hmm. That's the same old, same old.
Yeah.
And the last one, I call it focus on the farm team. So this is basically keeping in mind that one day you're going to be doing this for somebody who is very prominent. A celebrity, a politician, you know, a key community influencer. But if you practice it day after day after day after day on the average everyday people you meet, it's going to be ingrained and automatic. And I tell a story about that in the book. I say, all of a sudden, I just knew what to do when I met these people because I'd been doing it for all these other people right up until the day I did it.
Which is smart. We're running out of time. We have 2 minutes. Businesses want to have influence in the community, in the marketplace that they're trying to serve. How do you suggest a business gets that influence? It's easy to say, I want it, but to actually have it is something different.
Everything boils down to how good of a job you can do at creating what I call your own unpaid sales force.
Your own boss,
right?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
So you multiply the message that you bring by instilling it in other people through adding value to them in the back and forth of relationships.
Mm.
And they begin to say it for you rather than you have to say it for yourself. So what happened for me was by the time I left the insurance business, I would literally sit in my office and wait for the phone to ring. And it rang, right? It wasn't like the person sitting there waiting for the phone to ring and it doesn't ring. Mine actually rang, right? And that's what happens when you have 100 to 200 to how many, you know, if you want to take it to an international level, thousands or millions of people already trumpeting your message.
Within your network.
You don't have to do it for yourself. Yeah.
Wow, it sounds like a lot of it is creating relationships as well. You know, inevitably, whenever you're starting a business or, you know, whether you're years into it, you're going to hear a lot of no's. You're going to ask for things and you're going to hear no. Mm-hmm. How do we more often than not hear yeses?
I love that question, and here's why. I believe in saying let's leave no as an option, right? In other words, if you say it for them before they get the chance to say it as an option, not as a case closed, but say, look, I want you to understand no is always an answer.
Yeah.
It's perfectly okay to say no. What I don't really want you to say is I'll think about it.
Yeah.
You know, you can either say yes to me at the end of this and we can do business, great. If you say no, whatever that reason is, let's talk about it, and if we can overcome it, what answer does that leave? Mm-hmm. Yes.
So, don't just focus on pushing and selling, mm-hmm. But go, hey, no might be an option. So
let's find reasons not to do business, eliminate them, and then all that's left is reasons to do business.
About 15 seconds left, you have a special offer.
Go to thepaulsedwards.com/free-content. I've got a personal assessment, spouse survey, and a free copy of my book, plus you can get a 15-minute strategy call with me. I just added that in.
A spouse survey?
Spouse survey. You can find out all the bad things your spouse really thinks about you.
Wow.
I don't know about that one. I'm very fragile. It's great having you. Thank you so much. One more time, that special. Get a free copy of The Business Beyond Business, plus a personal assessment tool, a spouse survey, a goals and dreams worksheet, and he's going to give you that 15-minute consultation as well, which is pretty cool. The website, the number right there on your screen, rather the website's there on your screen, and take advantage of it today.
That's right. Get your copy of Business Beyond Business. You can also connect with Paul on his website, thepaulsedwards.com. He's on Facebook and Twitter. We didn't even get to mention he served time in the U.S. Army.
Oh, my goodness.
He did.
Thank you for your service.
Yeah. Bestseller Publishing, a proud sponsor of The Morning